Hey, how's everybody doing? Oh, of course, Mishka's got to come right over and get some attention. That little piece I was just hitting on, I'm actually making it's like a hot cut, but it's just to cut a little slit into pieces that are going to be for guard material. All right, so today I've got that big bill of Damascus I got to finish. That's heating up. I've got an integral bolster chef's knife that I'm working on in there, and that little chisel I'm making. Hey, thank you. I appreciate it, Tommy. The knife's already hot, so we're gonna go right over the power hammer and start getting that to shape. Back over here. All right. Hey, everybody, welcome to my Monday Live. I'm starting a little early. I may actually start doing this a little earlier than I was before. I was starting at 10 a.m. Pacific. I ended up waiting like an hour each time, and I don't like that. Anyways, So I've got a big villa of Damascus in the forge right now, right there. An integral bolster chef's knife that I'm working on, and a little chisel that I'm making. Now, the Damascus is going to take a while to heat up. It's a big billet. It's only 100 layers. That's all I want. However, there's a lot of steel there. So I'm going to be able to draw this out quite a bit. I'm going to have to cut it in half. I'm going for a quarter inch thick. So quarter inch by 4 inches wide. When you guys see the billet, you know what I mean. I'm going to have to cut it in half at some point. But right now, I'm going to rotate it. Oh, come on. The rest on the grinder. This will get a real basic heat treat. So set that aside for now. Okay, grab the inside of the hammer. Okay, so that spot that's curved down, that bottom side is going to be the edge. So I'm going to get a little bit more length out because the spine's really thick. Get a little bit more length out of it, and I'm going to keep it where the spine's curved down like that. Then when I switch to do the bevels, it's going to come up. It's going to pull that spine up and start looking like a real chef's knife. In the meantime, going to be the edge. I'm still really thick on that spine, so we're going to get nice and hot and go back over the power hammer. Okay. All right. Hey, everybody. Thanks for joining. My name is Brock. I am the owner and blacksmith of Woodson Knife Co. Yes, I'm forging on skates. Really, it just started on something that I thought up late at night and thought, what the heck. So, but it's fun. So, I've enjoyed it. This is the second time doing it. So, yeah, we've got that Damascus all heating up, and we're working on the chef's knife. Wow, Gunner, thanks. Why is it not a good idea, huh? I think it's funny because when we see stuff like this, people automatically, don't do it, don't do it, don't do it, that's dangerous. Have you ever seen stunts? Have you ever watched a movie where they do stunts? Yes, it's protected. Yes, they're careful. As am I. Fun until you lose a thumb. Why would I lose a thumb? Okay, Gunner. Well, I don't see why I would lose a thumb in this case, but okay. You do you. Worry about you. I'll worry about me. I just think it's funny when people get upset about it. All right. We're going back over here to the power hammer. And you know what? I gotta say, it's really funny because I know people that are less steady on shoes than I am on skates. Say if you don't like it, don't watch. Because I enjoy this, I have fun. And like I said, I'm steadier in skates than some people I know in their regular work boots. Which is just funny to me. But right, we're running at almost 2100 degrees. That big piece of Damascus really sucking up heat. Actually, I should rotate it. I don't know if you guys are going to be able to see it, though. So I'm trying this. I've seen a lot of bladesmiths doing this recently. I thought about it a long time ago, and now I'm actually doing it. So it's just a 1-inch piece of stock, and 1-inch Thank you. Yo, and Tommy, Gunner, I didn't mean to come across like I was pissed off or anything. It takes a lot to get me upset. But, no, I just, I think it's funny that that's the stuff as makers and that we get. You know, if you do something different or odd or take a risk, there's always people that are, you know, don't do it, the dangerous, whatever. Just let people have fun and enjoy their craft. Hey, no worries, man. You know, and I have a background in skating. Kind of a funny one, I guess. So I played roller derby for like 5 years. grew up skating, played men's and co-ed roller derby up until right before COVID, I think we is when I stopped. So alright. I'm gonna turn this. Yeah, see I played roller hockey when I was a kid. Ice skates were never my thing, partially because when I was younger, the first time I tried ice skates, I got a concussion, a really bad one, and so I stayed away from it for a long time. And the way your skates move on ice compared to roller skates is different enough that it messes with me. All right. Hold right now, the dies on the power hammer, the anvil, everything, because I'm just starting for the morning, and I don't really preheat anything. Oh yeah, I'm actually, on my mom's side, I'm the only male to have all my fingers, because of saws and other things. My grandfather lost his first, I think, two or three fingers when he was little. Picked up an unexploded round, or an unused round bullet, and it went off. At least that's the story I remember. Went off in his hand. So, but yeah, I my whole life, I've grown up around guys with, you know, not all their fingers from saws, and so I've been extremely careful when it comes to saws, especially table saws, because they'll screw with you. Thank you. All right, this should be hot enough.
Thank you.
take a little getting used to with that. I think the most dangerous part of this is actually filming it, because I have a power cord on the floor that I gotta keep track of. If ran into that, that'll make me stop really quick. This is 1085 Japanese cutlery steel. It's really good stuff. Sorry, I had an appointment reminder pop up for 9 o'clock, but it's 9 o'clock tomorrow. Anyways, you got to kind of forge it hotter than normal, I feel. Or at least you can't forge down to a lower temperature. Let's go with that. So once you start getting into those dark reds, you gotta stop. Thanks, Cutter. Okay, on this next one, I'm going to put the blade over the side of the anvil, because where my bolster is, the blade's popped up just a little bit, so I want to bring that down. I'm making an integral bolster chef's knife out of 1085 Japanese cutlery steel, and a very large piece of Damascus in there as well. I made is I cut that off the full bar a little too soon. All Yeah, when the blades start getting this thin, doesn't take very long to lose all the heat, but it also doesn't take very long to heat up. So I'll have that back over here in just a minute. Mine went way too quick, unfortunately. Knife is almost ready. And we dropped down to 8 people. Oh, there's 10. All right, hey everybody, do me a favor. Hit that like button. If you're on your phone, just tap on the screen. The more times you do it, the better. It's accumulative, and it helps me show up on more people's For You page. So likes, comments, shares, all that stuff is great. And I really appreciate it. back to the knife. So I've had the door shut significantly, not all the way, because we're in the porch. It was 4 degrees out this morning, so super cold. Yeah. So this blade is super thin now. It's not so thin I can't heat treat it, but it's going to be close. And that's why it's just, it'll lose its heat. Feels like almost instantly. Same time, it heats up really quick. I think that spine was hot enough to really do as much as I wanted to. So what I'm trying to do is bring that tip up just a little, maybe a half an inch. And then I'm gonna flip it over, isolate where the tang's gonna be, and draw that out. And grab my... new ugly tool. Straighten it up, do a little plane machine, because it's kind of warped. Rotating the Damascus billet. So after I finish this chef's knife, I'm going to put more of that same steel back in. And make another one. And potentially another one. We'll see. Uh-oh. So I ordered the pieces for this little guillotine, and let's just say my welding skills are subpar. I know that. But I'm working with a stick welder that can't get set up properly, and I just made a horrible mess of this thing. I almost threw it out. I just have to redo some stuff. I'm gonna cut it apart and remake it. Probably after I get a better welder. So I am low on gas. We're not out, but I'm pretty low on gas. So at some point in the next couple hours, I may have to run and get more gas. But I'll be back. Hey, welcome everybody. It's just joining. So I've got two pieces that I'm working on right now. That chef's knife you just saw, that's an integral bolster. It's going to be a hidden tang. And I've got a large billet of Damascus that I'm drawing out as well. Not the funniest thing to watch, but that's why I'm making these chef's knives along with it. So after I finish this one, I'm going to start a new chef's knife because I've got a lot that I need to make. Mm-hmm. people in here. Not bad, not bad. Hey, I really appreciate those likes. Keep those coming. They do really help the feed. Oh man, we're only at 217 likes. Usually by this time we're at like 5,000. Oh man. James, I'm sorry to hear that, man. But on the upside, man, you're on recovery. So that's good. I mean, things could be a lot worse. But I hope for a speedy recovery, man. I really do. And sorry you're going through that. That's rough. I do feel for you. So James has been a follower on here for TikTok for quite some time. Dirty. That's actually probably from that square pipe I'm using. Everything else I've got, the handles are pretty clean by now. I keep forgetting about my coffee and now it's cold. Serves me right. Back over to the press. Thank you. problem with this tube system is you have to carry it with the steel up. And I don't really care for that. But it's all right. That square tube thing, I don't know, maybe I'm just not used to it yet. However, my hand itself is less fatigued. But I don't know if I like it better than just using tongs. So, and if you weld the post and just leave it on, it gets hot all the way down and I gotta cool it off anyway. So, I don't know. There's no easy answer with that, I think. But it's one of those things I saw other bladesmiths trying, so monkey see, monkey do. Metal that you need to make a knife. Well, depends on what kind of tools you have. I'm not going to take my hat off again because that was scary. I got some gnarly hair going on. So it depends on what kind of tools you have. If you have a forge, and I say that because what I tell people to do is buy quality steel. Don't buy scrap steel. Don't go to the scrap yard. Buy quality steel. The price difference is not enough to justify buying unknown steel. Unless you get it for free and it's something you're just going to mess around with. Old leaf springs work. I've been told I think it was pre-74 or something like that. So into the 60s is great. Newer stuff, not so great. Regular car springs, not so great. But if you go to Pops Knives online, New Jersey Steel Baron online, you can order knife steel directly from them. Now, if you go pop signs, they got a whole wide range of stuff you can buy for knife making. I would recommend starting with 1084. It's easy to forge, moves fairly easy. The quenching process, the heat treat process is pretty straightforward, and it makes it a good knife. So I would say 1084, unless you are dead set on using unknown steel, go to Pops Knives or New Jersey Steel Baron. You know, and as far as it keeping a good edge for a long time, a lot of that's not just the steel. A lot of that is the heat treat. So if you're just starting out and you don't have a kiln, I recommend sending your blades out to get heat treated. You too, Joe. Glad you're here. Hey, not a problem. That's a lot of what I'm here for. If anybody has any questions about what I'm doing, put them in the comments. I will answer. Now, if you are interested in getting into knife making or bladesmithing, there is a difference. Check out my other videos. Also, go check out my Patreon. Just go to Patreon, type in Woodson Knife Co. You'll find it there. My goal through Patreon, and a lot of it on here, is to help people learn what I'm doing, and if they want to, go do it themselves. Wheelchair. Oh yeah, filming over here and I forget. Stupid. put this aside for now. Because the next step with that, I want to use the flattening dies in the press. We're not ready. There you go, I like it. You can do it. Hey, you can do it. I mean, you know, and I haven't been a bladesmith very long, and I haven't even been making knives for 3 years. Okay, so it's doable. Now, I learned things really quickly. My wife hates that fact about me, but I do learn things very quickly. However, I feel if I can do it in almost 3 years and be where I'm at, for the most part, as long as you have an artistic side and attention to detail, you can do this. It may take longer, but it's something you can learn. Oof. That's rough. Hammer for now. If I have to turn it back on, I will. I try not to turn it on and off very much. It's not really good for the machine. At least that's what the instructions said. It's so cold outside, I don't have a frost line on my tank, so I'm not sure how much I have left. Oh, there you go. So, now, maybe I just didn't catch this. Have you been forging, bladesmithing, all that before? All right. All right, so I put that bar of 1085 cutlery steel in there, so I'm going to start another knife. Run it almost 2100 degrees. It's 2090 degrees in there, slowly climbing. So I just wish I had an idea how much gas I had left in the tank. I know they have those level stickers. Maybe I should put one of those on there. Well, if you have a general idea of what you're doing, go for it. Now, I would say if you've got all the tools or access to all the tools, you know, and maybe somebody to teach you, learning this in a couple of years is very obtainable. You know, at least learning the major basics of it and being able to make a knife. Back to the press before we get that bar going. Nice. You know, and chef's knives are hard. The hardest part about chef's knives, in my opinion, is edge geometry and getting those bevels right. But it's doable. All right. So my post is breaking off per the norm. So I'm going to weld it back on. Thank you. All right. So I could do this on the... We are going to do this on the cover hammer. Because that's what I want to practice. I know I just turned this thing off. Got that back in. The Damascus is back in there. All right, so this big bill of Damascus, it's 100 layers. I'm going to draw it out. It's 4 inches wide. We're going to stay that width, and we're going to go to 1/4 inch thick. Then I'm going to take pieces out of that and use that into my depth kumai billets. Each side of the core on my depth kumai has a piece of copper and then 100 layers of Damascus. So that's what I'm making right now. I've got a few orders for depth kumai and completely out of billets. So yeah, and I tried rebar. I have a bunch of rebar for this, and I don't like it. The heat travels down way too quickly, you know, even if you're wearing gloves. Now, putting it upside down in water, trying to cool off the handle, so I thought this was just going to be a lot simpler. But it has its disadvantages, for sure, but so far it's okay. So I gotta wait for that bar stock to get nice and hot. I'm gonna isolate probably 6 inches of it, maybe a little more. She has to be the center of attention. Don't you? All right, well, good girl. All right, that's all she wrote. Okay, so running out of gas. I can't even increase the pressure anymore. It's so low. So what I just did was decrease the airflow, which brings the temperature up. Thank you. Yeah, she's a great dog. So Mishka is my service dog. So she goes everywhere with me. Can you go outside? You want to go outside? Okay. Damascus is ready. Over half an inch thick. Quite a ways to go. What I just did. I went to isolate it, blade it, and I did it way too thin. I shouldn't have pressed it that much, and right as I did it, I was in my head going, oh, damn it. I don't know why I did that. I know why I did it, because I was going hard presses with all the Damascus, switch over to that, I goofed up, but we'll see. Hey, thanks, Joseph. Appreciate it. Have a good one. Good luck with your endeavor. Hope it works out. So I got myself with the grinder, really good. Doesn't hurt anymore, but I have like half a fingernail. Not quite ready. So what I'm thinking with this is I'm going to try to widen it, and if it doesn't work, this is going to become something else. Damascus is probably going to be the last press on the Damascus until I get some more gas, because I'm pretty much out. Thank you. I think what I'm going to do after this next press with the Damascus, I'm going to set it aside, put that first chef's knife back in, start flanishing, straightening, all that good stuff, do all the finishing work on that chef's knife. I'm still going to work on the one I just started. If that even turns out to be a chef's knife, I don't know. We'll see. That mistake right at the beginning kind of took the wind out of my sails on that knife, but we'll get there. We'll get something. See if Misha needs back in. Misha. Too high up on that bar. I should have adjusted my camera beforehand. Guess I can't find my hearing protection. No, actually, but thanks for the smart owl comment. I have hearing aids. I don't need that because these block everything out. Take them out. I would need them, but yeah, I have hearing protection. Also, I gotta say, it's not as loud here as it is through the camera. I noticed that a long time ago, especially with the power hammer and the press. The press is not near this loud in person, but thank you. back over the power hammer. Put you guys up there. So, that thing, it's ugly right now. We'll see what that turns out to be. It's going to be a kitchen knife. Maybe a slicer. I don't know. It's not going to be a chef's knife because I can't get that keel down far enough, I don't think. But, hey, Wisconsin, how you doing? Hi from Washington State. Ooh, got my thumb pretty good. That was a burn, by the way. Losing heat so quick, and there's hardly any gas left, so. Trying to button everything up. There's still plenty of heat to do what I want to do in there. I think I'm going to do one more round with the power hammer on that, whatever that's going to be. Yes. Blood, sweat, and tears, and I don't think there's any part of my hands that haven't been cut or burned. I didn't even turn the camera. My bad. I'm sorry. That's how I am, too. I don't really care, though. It is what it is. Thank you. badges of honor for sure. Oh, I didn't notice the skates. Yeah. So I did this not last week, but the week before, and I had a lot of fun doing it. I feel very comfortable on skates, so. But I had a lot of fun doing it, so I wanted to do it again. I know some people enjoy it, some people hate it. I enjoy it, so I don't care. We're dropping temp significantly. We're down below 1900 degrees. Now for the one that's almost done, perfect. But the other one, it's gonna be a little difficult. We'll see. Oh, nice, Joe. That should be fun. Yeah, my oldest is in 29 Palms right now training. Probably absolutely hating life.
Alright, I still don't like that. A piece of forge scale fell off and stuck to my finger. It's never fun. It happens a lot. Alright, so I just don't like how that was looking. So we're gonna go to the anvil. So the bolster, whoops. The bolster is not centered in line with the blade. It's pretty good on the tank, but it's kind of kicked over on the blade. I can fix it. That's what I'm going to try to do now. After this, we'll go over to the vise, straighten everything out, and if it's still not quite in line, we'll fix it there. I can turn the air down and increase the temperature. So that's what I just did. Why I forgot that, I don't know. All right, on. Oh yeah, I think you told me that before. You guys got plans on what you're gonna do? Hey honey, how are you? Hope your morning has started good so far. Started good so far. I can talk. I can speak English, I promise. I hope your morning's going good so far. How about that? Yeah, honey, I bet you're vibrating. Oh, there you go. We're going to head over to the vise. That stupid cord. That's what I was saying earlier. The only part I don't like about doing this is the dang cord for this thing. But whatever. Just waiting for that to get up to temp again.
Hello.
It's closing up the forge a little bit more. Hey, I got something for everybody. Now, I don't know how many bladesmiths or potential bladesmiths I have in here, but I have decided to sell my Paragon. So, if you're interested, it's a super deep. Oops, it's a super deep kiln. I think it's a 36. I'm pretty sure it's a 36. But if you're interested, hit me up. Because it's like one step forward, two steps back. Just trying to refine everything, get it nice and straight. and not overdo it. Alright, there we go. So I got the spine lined up. There's some wonk in the blade towards the front, so we're going to heat that up. Yeah. Keep moving the power cord and I must bump it or something because it goes right back where it was. When I get back, I'm going to cut the ends off of that piece of Damascus, get rid of the scrap. It'll take some weight off of it, make it a little easier to handle. Now, I gotta kind of let go with this hand, or else I'll bend stuff. Spot that's not quite straight enough is the heel, but I'm going to heat it up, tap that into place on the anvil. Because it's like an eighth of an inch that's not in the right spot. All coming. still never finished my coffee. Actually more heat than I really need. Chef's knife. I'm curious how long this is. Hold on. Eight and a quarter. Hintang, integral bolster. So what I'll do next, clean up the profile, clean up the tang, all that, and we'll heat treat it. But for now, gotta hang it. Okay, so it's cold. All right, so I gotta go get more propane. As soon as I get that, get back here. I think I gotta run a couple other errands. One other errand, that's right. As soon as I get back here, get the forge back up to temp. I will come back on live, so watch for that. I don't know, probably be an hour or two, but hopefully not that long. So, hey. If I don't catch you later today, thanks for watching. As always, be kind. Much love. Have a great week.